2018 Volkswagen Passat GT first drive review vertical bar, no GTI, but pretty good VR6 power at a significant discount. The Volkswagen Passat is not a sedan known for sportiness. It's very spacious, and it comes in a plain and simple wrapper. That's why it was a bit of surprise when Volkswagen showed a concept for a GT version that looked like a big GTI, complete with black grille and red highlights, lower ride height and big wheels. It was even more surprising that the car, which VW said was developed by folks at the company's Tennessee facility playing around with ideas for what a Passat could be, became a production vehicle shown at this year's Detroit Auto Show. Readers will notice that the engine and transmission were not listed among the parts upgraded for the Passat GTI. It retains the same 3.6-liter narrow-angle V6, commonly known as the VR6, that you can get in the less sport-oriented Passat. Thankfully, it's still a reasonably powerful engine with 280 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque. That gives it roughly 30 more horsepower than many turbocharged 4-cylinder mid-size sedans, and a deficit of about 10 to 20 pound-feet of torque to many of those sedans. Still, the Toyota Camry V6 is whopping 301 horsepower and 267 pound-feet of torque outdo the VW, and the turbocharged Mazda 6 with its monstrous 310 pound-feet of torque remains the pulling king. The unchanged VR6 engine is coupled to the also unchanged 6-speed dual-clutch automatic transmission. This transmission is the only option for the Passat GT, which may come as a disappointment to those hoping for something that looks like a GTI. The reason for the lack of manual transmission is that Volkswagen discontinued manuals across the board for this generation, citing a take rate of less than 1%. Adding a new manual world added complexity and cost to the car. While the powertrain doesn't look particularly exciting on paper, it's actually rather enjoyable in practice. The VR6 is happy to rev and pulls well right up to redline. It also sounds excellent. This is helped in part by that revised exhaust system that, while not offering any extra power, does give the car extra growl. It's a nice deep tone with a hint of popping, and it sounds natural. The dual clutch transmission works well too. It does still have a little hesitation from a stop and at crawling speeds, but once you're on your way, it shifts impressively smoothly and quickly. It's quick to respond in manual mode too, so it makes for a fun, engaging powertrain when driving briskly. As mentioned, about the only significant performance upgrade the Passat GT gets is the new suspension. It has stiffer springs and shocks than normal models. The new suspension also lowers the Passat GT by 0.6 inch. What's really impressive is that the Passat GT is genuinely comfortable, the upside of not going full sports sedan. It's smooth for the most part, and while you feel some firmness over larger bumps, the impact is never harsh. We could almost see this suspension being used across the whole Passat line, but if the new Jetta is any indication, normal VW sedan buyers probably want their cars as soft as possible. So if you have even an ounce of desire for a decent handling car, this is the Passat to consider. All VW Passat GTs come with the same interior, which features black plastic and two-tone black and grey leatherette upholstery. There are a few small visual changes, including removal of the analog clock on the center stack in favor of a Passat logo, and the addition of a leather-wrapped steering wheel and stainless dorsal plates that say great. The front seats are heated, and the driver's seat gets power adjustments. Those front seats are pretty comfortable too, with thick padding that should stay comfortable over the long haul, and some light bolstering for support, if not a huge amount of security in tight turns. Like all other Passats, though, the GT has an advantage in rear passenger comfort. I was able to sit in the back with the driver's seat placed where I had left it, and I still had a good 4 to 6 inches between my knees and the back of the seat. The official measurement for rear legroom is 39.1 inches, which is slightly larger than a number of mid-size sedans, but is exceeded by the Honda Accord. It's a shame the front doesn't get as much space, which, at 42.4 inches, is more comparable to the tighter Mazda 6 and Ford Fusion. The 15.9 cubic foot trunk is also par for the course.